Good morning, children. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to DCEB Bioscience, DCEB Surya Patent Homomistic Bioscience online classes. This is Prasanna, working as CRT Biological Science, KGPB Palakkad, Surapet District. Children, as you know, we are discussing the lesson that is reproduction. In that, in today's class, let us know about reproductive health, birth control methods, and STDs, sexually transmitted diseases, especially about AIDS. Okay, children, in today's class, we are going to know about what is reproductive health and what are the birth control methods, what is contraception, what are contraceptives, and what are the contraceptive methods, how many types they have categorized, and then about STDs, different types of STDs, the sexually transmitted diseases, then about AIDS, how it is spreading, and what are the preventions. Okay, first, birth control methods. We need to birth, why do we need to control the birth rate? Because day by day the population is increasing at fast rate. So according to increasing population, there is a need to control the population growth. So why, what is the reason? So when a population is increasing day by day, so there is a need to provide a shelter, food shelter, and everything, every necessities we have to provide to the person, each and every person. Okay, so here population should be controlled. So by the population should be controlled by using the birth control methods. First, let us see what is contraception. So contraception means avoidance of pregnancy is called contraception, garbha nirodham. Okay, contraception. What are contraceptives? Contraceptive means the any device or chemicals which are used to prevent pregnancy is called contraceptives. Any device, chemical used to avoid pregnancy, prevent or avoid pregnancy. It's called contraceptives. Contraception means avoidance of or prevention of pregnancy when woman is not getting ready for pregnancy physically or mentally, or then pregnancy will be avoided. That is contraception. And to control the birth rate, women can use the any devices or chemicals in the form of contraceptives. So there are so many methods we have to control the birth rate. So first, physical methods. So condoms in males, diaphragms and cervical cap, and IUCDs, these two are in females. Condoms, we can see these condoms are used by males. That is a cover like structure that is made up of latex, and that is used for the penis of the males, so that prevents these condoms. Using condoms prevents not only prevents the entry of sperms, prevents entry of sperms into cervix of women during intercourse. Okay, by males. So, and these using condoms not only prevents the entry of sperms and also prevents the sexually transmitted diseases. Prevents STDs, sexually transmitted prevents sexually transmitted diseases by using condoms by males. Next, coming to the diaphragm, it is also called as cervical cap, used by females. That cap or diaphragm is arranged in cervix of the female. So, it cervix of the female, this diaphragm and cervical cap also prevents the entry of sperms in cervix. That's why we call it cervical cap. Okay, condoms and diaphragms. Diaphragms in females we can use prevent the sperms, entry of sperms in the cervix. Next, IUCDs are IUDs. IUCDs are IUDs. What is an IUD? Intra uterine contraceptive device, intrauterine contraceptive device, that is IUCDs. IUCDs are, you hear name itself, it is telling that intrauterine. The IUCDs are inserted in uterine, inside the uterine. So it prevents implantation. It prevents, not only prevents the entry of sperms and also prevents the implantation. Implantation in the uterus. Okay. Examples for IUCD is the best, most commonly used thing, that is copper T loop. Copper T is mostly used. The copper T is made up of ionized metal. Copper T is used of ionized metal, and it is used when a woman is when a woman does not want a children for many years. A parents need some gap between two children, so then they'll opt for the copper tea. That copper tea works for 3 to 5 years to avoid pregnancy. Next, okay, these three are the physical methods, physical devices we can use to prevent the contraception. And coming to the second one, that is chemical methods. There are several chemical methods we can see. Those are oral pills, vaginal pills mainly. Oral pills means some of the tablets are available in market. Those tablets we can take. These oral pills have the hormones like estrogen, progesterone, and which oral pills consist of hormones which regulates or prevents the ovulation. So every month in a menstruation cycle, we can see the ovulation takes place for every 28 days, once in every 28 days. See that ovulation, to prevent the ovulation, the oral pills are taken by the woman. These oral pills consist of hormones which prevents ovulation. And one more thing, the vaginal pills are also available. Vaginal pills are kept in vagina, and they have some chemicals which kills sperms. Kills sperms in vagina. So those are called as chemicals, or anyways, the chemicals which kill sperms are called as spermicides. Called as spermicides. So these are chemical methods, oral pills and vaginal pills. And next third one is surgical methods. Surgical methods are also called as the sterilization methods. Sterilization method. These are mainly followed. So the tubectomy and vasectomy, we used to hear these words, tubectomy and vasectomy. And children, after having one or two children, parents choose for this tubectomy or vasectomy? Okay, what is vasectomy? Vasectomy is, sorry, first tubectomy. Tubectomy is a surgical method. It is done in female or men. Female reproductive organs. You know, in the female reproductive organs, in that, there's a female reproductive tract, that is fallopian tube. Tubectomy is a surgical method that is the surgical method. The surgery is done in female, so there is a cut in female fallopian tube. Fallopian tube will be cut and tied or ligated. Fallopian tube will be cut and tied or ligated. The fallopian tube will cut and tied and ligated. That operation is done in females. That is called tubectomy. Okay, when they cut the fallopian tube and they tie it, so the sperm cells, sorry, the ovum or egg will, when the ovum or egg cannot be traveled through the fallopian tube, so that fertilization will not occur. So implantation will also stop by tubectomy. And next, vasectomy. Vasectomy. The surgical method done by males. So what happens in vasectomy? Vas means vas deferens. Cutting of vas deferens. Vas deferens will cut and tied or ligated. And this surgical method, the vasectomy done in males. And the vas deferens, which the shukra nalika, shukra vahika, the vas deferens will be cut and the tied and ligated so that the sperm cells which are released from the testes, they cannot travel through the vas deferens, so that the traveling of sperm cell towards the penis will be rejected, will be controlled. So that these two are the surgical methods most commonly are used surgical methods, tubectomy and vasectomy. Next, reproductive health is a state of physical, mental, social fitness. It's a state of physical, mental, social fitness to lead a safe and satisfying reproductive life. It's a reproductive health to be maintained. Okay, one should have the awareness about reproductive health. Okay, then many organizations are there, and government is also providing and encouraging to have the very happy and successful life. So children, next, in the next topic, let us know about the sexually transmitted diseases, STDs. STD stands for sexually transmitted diseases. First of all, in those, the sexually transmitted diseases take place because of unsafe sex. Okay, now? Because of unsafe sex. Here, some of the sexually transmitted diseases are here. AIDS. And some syphilis and gonorrhea. Okay, first let us know about AIDS. AIDS stands for acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. It's very important. The abbreviation is very important. Come for 1 month. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So, what is the casualty organism for AIDS? The casualty organism for AIDS is virus. That virus is what? Human immunodeficiency virus. What is that? Human immunodeficiency virus. Here itself, we can understand, in this disease, AIDS disease, damage our immune system. It affects the immune system. So, the virus, human immunodeficiency virus, that is HIV. I may ask this abbreviation also, HIV stands for. HIV, human immunodeficiency virus. It's a casualty organism, cause AIDS. Okay, what happens when AIDS disease is occurred in the body? The AIDS disease occurred in the body that leads to disorder in immune system. Our immune system or resistant power drastically collapsed, drastically affected during AIDS disease. So what are the organs are affected in AIDS disease? The AIDS human immunovirus disease virus affects the T lymphocyte cells in our body. T lymphocytes, very very important point you have to remember. In the disease of AIDS, what are the cells get damaged? Means that those are lymphocytes, T lymphocytes. Okay, T lymphocytes get damaged in the AIDS disease, and these T lymphocytes helps in the production of antibodies. Okay, when these T lymphocytes gets damaged, when this HIV virus affects the T lymphocytes, there will be no production of antibodies. You already know during this situation, pandemic situation, the corona is also affecting our antibody production, so that resistant power or immune system is drastically damaged. So same thing it is happening here, the T lymphocytes are getting damaged and antibody production is reducing, so that person, the AIDS person may expose her to many diseases, many infections. Okay, then next, AIDS is spread by unsafe sexual contact. By unsafe sexual contact, the AIDS is easily spreading. And also here, is there a treatment for this AIDS? No specific treatment yet. No specific treatment yet for AIDS disease. So some of the therapy treatments are there. That is ARP, antiretroviral treatment. ART centers you used to see in our villages, ART centers, antiretroviral treatment centers. So they control the conduct the antiretroviral treatment is like given to the AIDS patients and provide medicines to the AIDS patients. Next, how to control? So there is no cure for AIDS, so that to be controlled means that we should have an education and awareness about the transmission of AIDS. We should know the awareness about transmission of AIDS. Okay, so here some of the organizations and World Health Organizations, self organizations are conducting many programs and many awareness programs about the AIDS. So that in that ASHA and Red Ribbon Express are awareness programs about AIDS. ASHA stands for Accredited Social Health Activist. This abbreviation is also very important for one more. Remember this, note down ASHA, Accredited Social Health Activist. This and Red Ribbon Express, that these two programs are taken by the Government of India. Okay, then this is about AIDS. In AIDS disease, there is no treatment, only prevention is better than cure. Only prevention is the way to cure, to prevent the AIDS. See here, along with the AIDS, some of the sexually transmitted diseases are there. Those are syphilis and gonorrhea. So before this, the AIDS is not only spreading by unsafe sex, it also spreading by using infected devices, infected materials like after surgical devices, infected surgical devices or surgical infected needles, razors, and the person who is having the AIDS, and if that the person's infected blood transmission, if that person's blood is getting transmitted into another person, so by infected blood transmission, infected needles, infected razors, and in infected organ donations, during organ donation, and somewhat like from pregnancy mother to the baby also, the AIDS, there are many ways to spread AIDS easily can spread. So according to recent 2018-19 census, Andhra Pradesh stood in first place. Means that is not that Andhra Pradesh was in is in first place according to 2018-19 census. More AIDS patients are there in Andhra Pradesh. Nearly 2.14 lakhs. 2.14 lakhs of people. Lakhs of people living with AIDS in Andhra Pradesh. The statement is given recently 2018-19. Okay. This is about AIDS. So nearly next sir, the syphilis and gonorrhea. Syphilis is the casualty organism. Syphilis is it is caused by bacteria. That bacteria is Treponema pallidum. Bacteria is Treponema pallidum. So gonorrhea is also bacterial infection, bacterial device. That is the casualty organism is Neisseria gonorrhea. Neisseria gonorrhea. These two are bacterial infections. Syphilis and gonorrhea. These two are bacterial infections. And to these two diseases, there is a treatment using antibiotics. The syphilis and gonorrhea. Using antibiotics, the syphilis and gonorrhea can be cured. Okay, can be cured. And nearly not only this AIDS and this syphilis and gonorrhea, some of the genital warts are some cervical cancer, many diseases we can see the the spread through sexual unsafe sexual contacts. Okay, nearly 30 diseases are found easily spread through unsafe sexual contacts. They are also called as venereal diseases, means sukha vyadhi. Okay, next MTP. What is MTP? MTP stands for medical transmission of medical termination of pregnancy. What is that? Medical termination of pregnancy. So when a woman is not ready to get pregnancy, then there will be termination of pregnancy before 12 weeks of pregnancy. Means 12 weeks of pregnancy before the first trimester. That is called as 12 weeks of pregnancy is called as first trimester. Before 12 weeks of pregnancy, when a woman is not get ready to like physically or mentally or if any health issues if she has, then she is ready to like she choose to opt for the MTP, medical termination of pregnancy. That is in general we call as abortion. What is that? Abortion. But nowadays it is misusing. That MTP is misusing by many people who does not want a girl child. Female girl child, okay, a female child who does not want a female child, so they are committing to kill the female girl child in easily. That is female feticide. We call it as a female feticide. We should say strictly say no to female feticide. Without female, there is no world. Because female, so that because of female feticide, there will be the female number is rapidly reducing. Reducing in number, the female and male sex ratio is not in balance. So we should maintain the female and male sex ratio. So we should always say no to female feticide and say no to STDs and say no to girl child marriages. Here, children, the government of India is like announced that a marriageable age. It is also very very important, children. One bit they ask marriageable age. Age for a girl is 18 years. Okay, 18 years. A marriageable age for a boy is 21 years. Okay, marriageable age for a girl is 18 years. A boy is 21 years. Very, very important. You should remember it. Anything in mind? So to have a healthy society, it is very important to maintain female and male sex ratio. So save, let us discuss, let us say some slogans. Save girl child, think a world without girl. Save girl child, think a world without girl. Because to stop female feticide. Stop female feticide, save girl child. Stop female feticide, save girl child. If we kill future mother now, if we kill future mother now, who will give birth to us in future? If we kill future mother now, who will give birth to our future? Birth in our future. Okay, these are the female feticide slogans of to stop female feticide. This is about today's topic: reproductive health, birth control methods, and sexually transmitted diseases, especially the AIDS and syphilis, gonorrhea, and genital warts, and marriageable age for girl and boys. What is tubectomy and vasectomy? This is all about children. I think did you all understand today's topic? I think you all are understand well. Till up to here, the reproduction topic is finished. Tomorrow, after tomorrow onwards, classes will be begin. So all the best, children. Thank you. Thank you very much.